Hello, in this video we learn about log4j example in Java programming, and for this we need Java installed in your system, log4j jar in downloaded from that internet, Eclipse installed in your system, and any operating Windows operating system. After that we'll see how to create a new Java project, Java project creation in Eclipse, how to add log4j jar in project. We add that log4j properties file, Java class for log4j, someone Java file. We discuss about console appender and rolling file appender, and in detailed discussions we'll discuss more about the why we use the priority.java file, which is part of a log4j, and we'll discuss more about that log4j property while changing that to different property and value accordingly. So for this I have just referred that to some website which is nothing but a login services, login.apache.org log4j, and you can see that definitions and all from here, like why login, why log4j, performance and all. So in brief, you can see that a more details from that log4j wiki as well, and about license and all written in his region, and you have to have understand more about log4j log label, like off, fatal, error, warn, info, debug and trace. We'll see one by one in more details. On I have just downloaded log4j from download link, and it will come as this ones. You have to click latest one, this link, and it will be downloaded like that. You have to right click and show the folder, it will go to the folder. I have already downloaded and it's there in my directory. It's there in a lib directory, and I have placed that a jar file over here. Just I extracted. After extracting you'll see something like that. Then you have to go to over here, that lib will be there, and we have to place that somewhere else. So I have placed that library over here, and executable jar or log4j jar, whatever is required. Now we'll see that how to create the project, and one by one. So first of all what we need Eclipse. So you have, I'm assuming you have already installed. After installations you have to just double click on Eclipse icon. The Eclipse will be open like this one, and don't assume this will be not there in your system. I have did that, so it is there. After that you have to check that a Java install or not. So I have already installed that Java, and it's there, and after that Eclipse is there, configure with that. And you have to create one log directory where we are going to place that your log file, for example C workspace log or somewhere else, whatever is feasible in your system. Then after library we downloaded, we created log4j directory, like workspace log I am going to use, and after JDK and Eclipse is installed. Now we'll go and create that Java project. Then what you have to do, just go to file, new, and Java project. Type the name of the project is, I'll just copy paste because I have already did that. Java project, name of the project will be log4j examples in Java programming with Eclipse, and put that your workspace whatever you want. I'm using the DKI 1.8, so let it be 1.8. Create a separate folder for class file, and if you want, then you can configure where you want to put that source file, where you want to put the class file. Apply, then click on OK. I'm using working set, so I have added that to Java. Click on that next. After that, it will prompt that your class file is going to put a default output in class folder. SRC folder will be there, and we have to click finish. So we got that Java project over here. Now we got that Java project SRC and library is there for JDK 1.8. What we need now, we need a two thing. One thing, I'm just copying pasting. After that, we have to, okay, then we'll discuss one by one. Oh, copy. I'm little bit lazy, so I don't want to write anything. And we have to create one Java class file. Okay, hold on, I think I'll cut over here. I'll paste that in Notepad. I'll remove, copy this file as well. Okay, now we got that created that Java project. Don't confuse with my rubbish step. So I'm considering after creating the Java project, we got that SRC on JRE. So after that, we have to create one Java class file, and that class file name will be there like what, log4 j info example in Java programming. I'll put that log4 j example in Java programming. We'll put that package name com.a2z example. So you have to type that a package name, like your name of a package. I'm just using com.a2z examples. And then the name of Java class, I'm going to use that log4j example in Java programming, and click on the public statics void main method, then click on finish. After that, you'll get similar like this ones. Then you have to type something. It's saying that we have to do something, so I'm going and removing it. Over here we'll add something other than that. Now after that, we need to add that a few lines which will be indicate okay. So we have to implement a logger, then after that a class, we have to have write that a final statics class level object of a logger, name of a logger object, and logger dot get loader, and for which class we are going to load that. So I have to type that a name of a class where we want to load with help of a that reference and dot extensions of that class. So while adding this ones, it's getting that a logger cannot be resolved to a type because it's asking we have to import it. So now we are using that log4j with a Apache log4j org Apache, but another logger is also there with a login utility. So this is the part of a Java, and we are, I'm not going to explain in more about this. As of now, we are going to discuss log4j. Then it's saying that we need a jar file, and we have to configure that the jar file in this project. So jar file is already there, log4j. We have to go into that our actual project, and over here I'll place it, or we can put that in somewhere else as well. Now if I'll refresh it, so that jar is there, but still we are getting, because that's there in configurations but it's not in actual. So what you have to do, just right click on that project, go to build path, configure build path, then add jars. It will come to that like your project, and then you have to select the jar file, then OK, jar added, then click on apply, click on OK. Now it's maintaining a reference for that project. If you go over here, now we are getting org apache log4j or java util login. So we have to choose org apache log4j, then click OK. Now that error is finished. So again you have to control S, save. We got a logger reference for Apache. We don't have a source for this, otherwise we can see that all whatever is there, but anyhow you can see that specifications of that while clicking on control and click, then you will go to that the class. Now we got that a logger object. With help of that logger object, we can implement, just click on name of a object and then info, it's asking message, just type that this is the info by log4j, control S and then control shift F. So it will format that. Now we got that we already written that one class file project. We implemented that log4j jar in that project like a configure. If you run this one, then we'll see that some error message. It will ask. We got that a warning, which is nothing but log4j warning. No appender could be found for logger. Reason why is for this class we have not configured yet any initializations for log4j. So initializations that will be done by log4j property by programming, and third one by XML file. So several way we can do that. So we'll check that log4j property file. So for log4j property file, we have to create that one file, and it will be required in src folder. log4j properties, and then click on finish. I have to type that. We'll discuss that one by one. What is this? And then we have to run it. So after that, that logger will be identified. That okay, the logger identified name of the file and all, but where that file is creating, we have to change that. It's creating then C workspace log log4j applications. We'll see in details. So what I we did that, as of now we have a std out and only log info is there. Just we have created that one aesthetics object, class label object, and for logger, and we just pass that a parameter name of a class. After that we got that a logger object, that is a static, so we can use that anywhere in this class. And with help of that object, just I implemented that info, and before implementing this, we need a one of the append like way to implement that. If you not configure that, then we'll get that error message, warning message. If you not configure that log appender by log4j property or XML or programming, then you'll get that such kinds of error message, and it will be not load that in logger meshes. Now we got that we'll see that log file is generating or not in this location, C workspace log and then name of a file. So this is there, C workspace log and something like that. I'll remove this one. I'll run that applications again. Wow, so I'm getting that message in console as well as in a log file as well. So same message is printing in log file as well. We'll modify something in patterns and all, we'll see. So why we are getting message in console in log4j, we have to understand. So for root label, I have configured that log4j root logger trace. So this is that way, if you'll see that log label, you'll understand wiki, come all the way down. So we have a log4j log label. Log label is nothing but off. If you'll put that off, it will turn off login entirely. If you'll put the fatal, that fatal message will become. If you put that error message will become. If you put the debug, then info warning until debug will become. If you put the trace, everything will become in this one. So we have to see that how that will be happen. And before going ahead, you must aware about that what is logger. So logger are logical local log files name, appender and then layout. So with help of that appender, the file appender will be there, daily rolling file appender will be, console appender will be there, socket appender will be there, syslog appender will be there, and also you have to understand these three terminology. If you want to find that that best way to implement log4j in JVM property with help of a dlog4j, if you are running that log label with help of a only console applications, if you want to find that your where that log4j property file with help of a that, you can find it or XML file if any. We'll change the value of that and we'll see. So as of now, it's printing to sysout and file. So sysout is nothing but one of that appenders category where we are going to append. So log4j, I'm using appender, then sysout. That means it will be there in console and it will print. And we appender sysout, we are using console appender. And what is that? System.out. So whatever message it will become, it will print that in console. And pattern layout, which pattern we are going to print. As of now, it's date, then info, then name of a class, and then message. So if you'll change the format, for example, I'm going to change that, removing this one. Control C. Now earlier we are getting the output like this one. After changing the format, we'll get that output something like different, because now that format we have removed, that which is nothing but percent minus 5p percent 1c something like that. So for if you want to see that this layout, you can go ahead with this one, come all the way down. And you will be see that what is the meaning of a percent R, percent T, percent P, percent C, X, M and N for new line, something like that. So with help of that, if you want to put that in only DD, you don't want to print that a year, then just remove this one. So earlier we are getting that year, then month and time. Now only month and date is there. So just go through that in more detail, change it all below, and you will see that the output for that. So this is all about the console, and for second one is nothing but profile, whatever out message we are getting, same instead redirecting to that in a file as well. So this is for file appender. If we change that anything, any value in over here, that will be reflect in a file. For example, we'll see that this is nothing but a log4j appender for file, rolling file appender. Rolling file appender is nothing but if you put that a max file size and max backup index, then it will be changed that once the file will reach on that limit. For example, I put that max file size is 1 KB, a max backup index is 2. So what will be happen, we'll see. So as of now, for this we need something more message. I less than, I greater than equals to 200. Okay, I less than equals to 200, I plus plus. Okay, so we'll get that some more messages, and it's asking for saving. We got, these are the messages. I just print that a for statement. Now we got that a two file and all. Earlier there was only one file, but it's got a size of a more than 1 KB, and it's created two more index, and it's log that information over here. I'll remove all, nothing is there in log directory. I'll put that index positions for 5. So, and okay, now we got that index positions of 5. So latest informations will be there. If that file will be reached to 1 KB, then it will go to that index 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 5. And so accordingly, if we'll change that 1 KB to more than that, then it may be, if I'll put that 100 KB, then it may be the file index will be not there, because we don't have that much of message in our log info. Run it. Now we got that only one file, because size is 18 KB only. If I'll put that, now with help of that we are getting that size is 80 KB, so I put that a 15 KB over here. And if I'll run that applications, because if I'll print this message, it's 200th time, then it's 80 KB. Now we got, okay, so before that we have to remove this one again, run it, otherwise it's taking old message as well. Now we got that 16 KB plus 3 KB, that means key 16 KB, it's like in index 1, and rest of the data is there in a index 1. So if you read this message in another file, then it will come altogether 18 KB. So with help of that, you can change that one by one property for this one. And well, if you put that max index backup, so automatically the backup file, there is no need to housekeeping and all, the file will be removed. Again, there is a Python layout, which Python you want to print in your log file. And for easy identifications, so date, year, month, date, then hour, minute, second, then which category of information's name of a class where we are getting, and then 14 we are getting that. So 14 will check, what is that, is that line number. So that is a nothing but a 14 is a line number we are getting that. So from 40 numbers, if you put that a 15, okay, now and we'll comment this one, not required. and Milrani again. So we got that one is info is printing in line number 14 and second one is there in 16. So that line number is coming from L, hopefully. I'm not sure about that. Okay, no problem. So till yet we just implemented a logger and for info with help of std out and file. I don't want to print this message in std out, so what we have to do, we have to remove that std out from here, and we can remove that as well. If you want, you can remove over here, not required. If you want, let it be as it is, just remove from over here, parent level, and it will be removed. So if I'll run, we are not getting in console. However, we'll remove that log file. We'll run one more time. Okay, so we got that in console, log file error message. However, we didn't get that in a console. So if you want to print that only on console and not in file, just comment it. Okay, and run that this one. Before that, remove this file, so it will make sure we are not generating any file. Run it. So we will got that in console, but we didn't get that in a file. Okay, so I'll let it be as it is, both file and console. We'll see what is the first log label. As of now, I have printed that a trace. So with help of a trace, everything will be printed like logger dot debug if I'll print that a logger dot in, if I'll print that a logger dot fatal. Okay, FTL fatal. So info debug error warning, info and then debug, will put the debug one, will put that one message in error, will put that error message fatal, will put that fatal, control Z fatal. So we got that info debug one error and fatal, and our configurations is there for trace. So it will print, and before that I'll remove again log file if any not there. Okay, so now if I'll run, we got that all info debug one error and fatal. However, if I'll set that error now or only debug, so if I'll put the till debug, okay, so why we got, because we need to type this value in caps. DBUG. Okay, trace error will say ERROR. Okay, so if I'll put that, reduce that label only error. So after that error, that priority will be like a fatal and error similar. So both is coming fatal, but for debug it's coming all, because we want to debug and there you have priority. If I'll put that only log label info, then only info messages will be printed. Okay, so after that the info all is printing, info one error and fatal debug is like in excluding. So according if you change that value over here, you will see that which logger you want to. So with help of that we can reduce that. If you want to only fatal, only fatal, then error and fatal will become something like that. Only fatal message is coming, right? So this is way for reducing and enabling, disabling whatever you want, because at the end of a logger will be reduced, that like your slowness of with applications along with include that your maximum code size length as well. After that we have to learn few things more. If you want to put something conditions is info enabled, then only this will be print. So better way, so once this will be enabled, then only it will be print even though. And if debug is enabled, then the debug message will be print. Okay, so with help of that, now we'll see if that is enabled. This is the best way to write that code. Then only this will be print, like info or debug. It will definitely it's increasing that your line of a code, but that's a better practice for doing that in actual implementations. So this is all about. And same thing, if you want to implement in other class, only you have to just add this line. I'm just going to recap what we have did, that one Java installations is required. Eclipse, I'm considering you have installed, and you have downloaded the log4j jar file. After that log4j jar file, then in Eclipse we have created new project called log4j example in Java programming with Eclipse. We have added that one Java class, we have added that log4j property with a root label and a std out and file label, so we can enable disable with help of while commenting this one. And file appender we can put that the size increasing decreasing over here. Then layout we can change that like Python layout whatever you want. And we have added that log4j jar in that project. This is all about log4j implementations in a Java programming. I'm hoping you have learned and enjoy while watching my video. Please like and share it, and don't forget to subscribe.